Ubuntu 17.10 was released a week ago. I have installed it on my computer almost immediately. I tested it for a week, and now I am ready to share with you what was good, what was bad, and what was ugly. This is my review of Ubuntu 17.10. Hello everyone, it's a Rich Linux user, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. If you want to learn more about Linux, please subscribe and click on the bell notification, so you won't miss any new video. I usually don't pay attention to .10 releases of Ubuntu, but Ubuntu 17.10 is a very special release. You probably heard that Ubuntu was going to switch from Unity to GNOME 3. Now it happened. Ubuntu 17.10 is the first release with the GNOME 3 desktop, also known as GNOME Shell. I have installed it on my hardware last Thursday, when it was released. I tested it for almost a week, and now I am ready to share with you my thoughts on Ubuntu 17.10. I'm not going to show you everything that is new with this Ubuntu release. There are already many YouTube videos on this topic, and you can also find all this information in the release notes. In this review, I will show you what, in my totally subjective opinion, is good, bad, and ugly about Ubuntu 17.10. Let's start with the good. It looks similar to Unity. When Mark Shuttleworth announced that Ubuntu would move to GNOME, there was a lot of discussion about whether Ubuntu will use vanilla GNOME or make it look similar to Unity. Now we can see that it has the layout that strongly resembles Unity. So it is good, because it looks familiar to former Unity users. I also find the position of the main panel on the left the most productive. If you don't like it, luckily there is an option to move it down. Or to the right, if it is your preference. I also think it is good because this layout is also strongly associated with Ubuntu distro. It is sort of branding of Ubuntu. So it is good that Ubuntu has its own unique look, and it sticks with it in this GNOME desktop. It is surprisingly stable. I will be honest with you, when I installed it, I expected it to perform poorly. You know, the first release with GNOME, the transition to Wayland, there were too many things which could go wrong. However, the installation process and the overall performance were great for me. My hardware is sort of designed for Linux, and I try to keep it simple. I don't use a dedicated video card that requires proprietary drivers, nor I have Bluetooth or any other things which may not work correctly with Linux. So your experience may differ from mine. But I can compare this Ubuntu with Fedora 26, which also uses GNOME Desktop and Wayland Display Manager by default. And Fedora 26 is also installed on this computer. And here comes my third point for the good. Ubuntu works very smooth with Wayland. It feels as good as Xorg, or even better. Login is fast and all transitions and effects work fine. On the other hand, in Fedora, login with Wayland Display Manager was slow. After I enter my password in the login screen and press enter, I have to wait around 5 seconds to see the desktop. Also, some applications freeze often. Nothing like this happened to me with Ubuntu. But even if Wayland doesn't work for you, you can always change back to Xorg. There is an option to select it in the login screen. The next point is my favorite, the night mode. I think every desktop should have this feature by default. The night mode reduces the amount of blue light in your screen after the sunset. This helps not only to reduce eye strain, but it also reduces the negative effect on the production of the hormone melatonin that regulates sleep and wakefulness. So with this feature enabled, you should have less problems with falling asleep after sitting in front of the computer at night. It is so easy to configure. You just go to the settings and set it on. The last good point is Ubuntu is not boring anymore. Ubuntu with Unity desktop just became boring. There were no many new features in every new release with Unity. Ubuntu looked and felt the same. Ubuntu with Unity was truly lagging behind the development pace of GNOME and Plasma 5. The Ubuntu team probably had no enough resources to maintain and at the same time to develop new features of Unity. They tried to innovate with Unity 8, but it didn't work. Now, the Ubuntu team will not do all the work alone. A larger part of work will be done by the GNOME community, and the Ubuntu team can polish, fine-tune, and modify already developed GNOME desktop. I hope with GNOME desktop, the development of Ubuntu will be more dynamic. Now we start with the bad. Ubuntu changed again. As far as I remember, Ubuntu started to move down in distrowatch ranking after they switched to Unity. Users usually don't like dramatic changes. They want a familiar desktop. So I predict with this switch to GNOME, the popularity of Ubuntu will go down again. Actually, it is already even below Manjaro. I know, distrowatch ranking might not reflect the reality, but this is what we have. The current state of Ubuntu GNOME desktop is rather the downgrade in comparison to what Unity delivered. And here come these downgrades. There is no global menu by default. And it seems like there is no way to add the global menu extension. This is because GNOME global menu extension doesn't work with Wayland yet. The only way to use this global menu extension is to switch to Xorg from Wayland. But if you want to use Wayland, you have to live without the global menu and have some wasted space in the top. Another bad thing, which I didn't notice immediately, but after some use, I really started to feel the need of it. There is no Show Desktop button. Maybe it is not a popular feature nowadays and nobody uses it, but I like to clean my desktop by minimizing all apps with one click. The next bad thing is again related to this new dock. When you click on the icon of any app, this app doesn't minimize. It was the most annoying drawback in Unity, and it was the major reason I could not use Unity full-time. You may say there is a minimize button on the window, use it. But it is less convenient. It is small, not easy to aim, and if I want to check some apps for a moment, I just want to click on it, see what's happening in the app, and click again to minimize it. But I cannot do that with this dock. I need to move my mouse to this button, which now very far away in the right corner, and click on it. When I used Unity, I had a workaround. I used a custom keyboard shortcut to minimize windows, but I still would prefer to use my mouse. The last bad thing, before we move to the ugly things, is that the dock shows apps from all desktops. For example, if I open Calendar, and I don't want it to take space in this dock and this desktop, I move it to another desktop. But its app icon is still present on all desktops. And it is active. The same applies to Alt-Tab switch. Imagine having dozens of apps open. Even if you distribute them into different desktops, you would still need to scroll through all of them to find the one you need. Seriously, it is just a disaster. Now I would like to show you some less critical issues, which don't affect the use of the desktop too much, but they are still desirable to improve or change. The first problem is this one. When you click on LibreOffice Maximize button to minimize it, it collapses to this small window. I first thought it was a bug, but I quite quickly realized that it was just a small window, and it can be manually expanded. After this, the Maximize button works correctly. The next ugly aspect is that the Show Application menu is at the bottom. If you ever used Unity, you probably remember that the Menu button was in the top left corner. Now we have Activities here in the top left corner, and the Application button at the bottom. You actually can use Activities to launch an app as well. You just need to type its name and press Enter. But if you want to scroll through all available apps, you need to click on this menu. Honestly, I think it makes some sense to separate these two options, but during my use, it was confusing. I used to click on activities pretty quickly, because it is how you interact with the system most of the time. But when I wanted to open the menu, I would still click on activities. It became a habit. Then you cannot click somewhere else to go back. You need to either select an open app, or go back and click on the activities again. You can also press Escape. And after that, I would go down and open the menu. Maybe I need time to get used to all these features, but I prefer to have one single menu. Even the vanilla GNOME desktop was more intuitive for me in this regard. The next ugly thing is that window buttons on the right. I know, it is debatable, and users coming from Windows would probably prefer it this way. But buttons on the left are way more efficient. All the elements in this desktop are located on the left. The mouse pointer spent most of its time here. Why do I have to move it far to the right? Maybe someone will disagree with me, but the position of Windows buttons on the left is what I consider a right position. When I switched to Linux, I also felt uncomfortable with these buttons on the left. But after some time, I realized how convenient it was. And the last three ugly things. You still may get occasional glitches with Wayland. I have seen some screen tearing issues when I opened Firefox. Unfortunately, I was not recording at that time, and I was not able to reproduce that issue. But Wayland is still pretty new, and some small problems may arise. Another problem I faced was the user settings dialog freezes often. I have seen the same problem in Fedora, so probably it is a GNOME problem, not Ubuntu. The user settings are not visited often, so it is an unpleasant problem, but it's not critical. And the last small issue, there is no 32-bit version anymore. I personally think it is the right time to abandon the 32-bit ISO. But I know, this may affect some users, so I decided to mention it too. Ubuntu 17.10 brings many changes, but for the end user, most of these changes, unfortunately, don't improve anything compared to the previous release of Ubuntu with the Unity desktop. Ubuntu 17.10 is a transitional release, as most of the .10 releases of Ubuntu, so it is expected to be not perfect. I hope most of the downsides I mentioned in this video will be addressed in the next release of Ubuntu. On the positive side, I was already very impressed with the performance of Wayland in this release. So, the next release, Ubuntu 18.04, will be very exciting. What is your opinion about Ubuntu 17.10? I'm looking forward to reading your comments. Thank you for watching!